To all my viewers, I welcome you all to the morning session of my lecture, online lecture, and I hope all of you are able to understand and get benefited out of my online lectures, children. Today I'm with a new topic, and that is advertisement from your, writing section. This question carries 4 marks in the board examination, children. And moving ahead to the next slide, let me ask you, what is an advertisement, children? Advertisement is a public notice or announcement on a public platform. Now, what do you mean by public platform? Example, there are the newspapers, the magazines, TV, mass media, etc., promoting or offering a product, service, or even an event, or publicizing a job vacancy. It is an important tool for promoting sales or services, children. Okay, this section, deals only with newspaper advertisements, which fall under 2 broad categories. The first one is classified advertisement, and the second is display or non-classified advertisement. Okay, children, now I would like to ask you, children, what is a classified advertisement? What is a classified advertisement? These advertisements are written in a very peculiar style. They are called classified as they are grouped into categories or classes according to the subject matter. They are like the matrimonial, situation vacant, property for sale, etc. Now, classified ads, they are written very briefly and grouped into categories. Okay, now children, I would like to ask you, how classified advertisements are drafted? I would like to tell you, they are written in the form of a simple paragraph, consist of only specific information about the goods, products and services. We do not use the helping verbs is, am, are. The word limit for classified advertisement is just 50 words. Okay, children. Now, next slide is, I would like to explain to you the types of classified advertisements. Okay, there are different types of classified advertisements. I told you they come under different categories. The first one is situation vacant, situation wanted. Second is for sale, for purchase, to let, matrimonial ads, educational institutions, tuitions, tours and travels, missing person or pet it can be, or any article too, lost and found, packers and movers, advertisements. Now, what is the purpose of writing classified advertisements? One side of the slide I have written the advertisement word, and the other side is purpose. So let me tell you, what is the purpose of writing, publicizing the situation vacant ad? This is written by an employer. Situation vacant means any organization or a firm that is in need of an, employee. So that they publish, the employer writes this ad. Okay, next is the situation wanted. This is written by the job seekers who are in need of a job. For sale. Now you want to sell your products, the assets of the office, or the goods, the household goods, anything you can sell. For purchase, this is put up by someone who is looking for suitable assets, okay, or property, vehicles, goods, furnitures, who wish to purchase something, right, children? And the next one is the matrimonial. See, we are in search of a prospective for marriage candidates, then we publish such ads which are known as the matrimonial ads. Okay, these are written while looking for prospective marriage candidates. The next one again is the missing. When do we publish a missing ad? If any object, person, pet goes missing, giving details for the same. And the next one is the educational institutions or the new tuition classes that you set up. This is to announce it is an announcement made by educational institutions, children. Okay, the next one is, and the purpose of publishing the education institution ads is because they announce regarding courses, diplomas, degrees it offers. And the next ad that is published is classified ad is tours and travel, children. This advertisement is about tours and travel, by tours and travel agency, etc. Okay, now children, I would like to tell you that before you begin to write your classified ads, you need to, you know, keep in mind certain important points while drafting the classified advertisements. Put the heading in the center of the top line. It is written in a neat and rectangular box. Write the body or the content of classified advertisement, providing only essential information. Provide the contact details at the end. They must include the name, address and phone number as per requirement. Next point, use third person narrative or third person pronoun. Okay, provide relevant information briefly in every short sentence, in phrases, words punctuated by commas, semicolons or full stops. Got it, children? Now, what is the bifurcation of the marks? You know, the bifurcation part contains three parts. First is the format. The format includes the box, heading, the contact address when you're writing a classified advertisement, and this carries one mark. Content, you need to give special information, that important specific information to be written in 50 words. Expression part, do not use grammar. No complete statements are to be written, and it is written in a simple paragraph that carries one mark. Okay, children? In the next slide, I have given you an example of classified ad here. And I hope you try to understand what is there. There's all theoretical written here. No images or no pictures or no sketches in it. No different font sizes. Just a simple language which is containing only specific information. But before I proceed ahead, I would like to tell you that in every category of the ad, you are supposed to add the value points. Now, children, I would like to tell you, if there's, you need to publish a matrimonial advertisement and you are wanting a, you know, groom for your daughter. So what are those points that you need to add? The beauty and looks of the girl you need to mention. Upbringing and manners, education, working or non-working the girl is, age, height, complexion, caste, religion, what sort of marriage do you need, early marriage or simple marriage, the family background, details of the prospective bridegroom. You need to even write, you know what type of the groom you need for that daughter of yours, contact address and telephone number. Same is with the groom. You need to mention handsome, smart, okay, boy, well settled in business or job, income, education, property, complexion, age, height, caste, religion, family background, details of the prospective bride, okay, contact address and telephone number. Suppose, children, in the next category, we have a two-let ad. You want to rent your house or you wish to sell it. Okay? So, what are you going to write? Number of bedrooms, size of room, drawing come dining room, type of bathroom, type of kitchen, modular kitchen you write, floor, whether it is tiled or it is the well-furnished, lawn, garden, direction, location, corner house, park facing,
condition of construction, electricity, locality, contact, okay, what time they need to contact, schedule for site visit, preference, executive offices, companies, small families, rent expected, contact address, phone number. Overall, whatever, see, when you want to sell your own house, you definitely speak good about it. So see that whatever points you are adding, they should be genuine, and plus they should be written in words or phrases. Next is job wanted, or you know, the first one that I said, it is job wanted or situation vacant. I told you situation vacant is when we need to, okay, children, in this situation vacant, we need to mention the name of the organization, address, PO box number, name of vacancy, number of vacancies, essential qualification, preferences, whom would you like to appoint, male or female, knowledge of computers, additional qualifications, working environment, working hours, salary and perks promised, opportunities for promotion, application, interview procedure. You need to mention all these things, contact address, okay? And suppose job wanted or situation wanted. Situation wanted means you are in need of a job. You are a job seeker. And what are those points that you need to add, the value points? You need to give your personal details, your age, health, sex, education, profession, okay? And experience, other qualities, type of job, area, you know, locality, emoluments, contact number, you can give. Now children, suppose you want to sell your plot, you need to mention the area in square yards, locality, situation again, whether it is a corner plot or it is facing the park or it is on the highway, NH1, name of promoter, then allotment details you have to give, price expected, details of development of the area. And this plot would be suitable for what purpose, whether it is for residential area, godams, commercial, industrial areas, softwares, IT companies, transport companies, or whatever you want to mention, it would be suitable for what, this particular plot that you wish to sell. You can give the contact number and as well as your address, children. And category that you can take up is missing. You know, missing, if even a person can miss, your dog can miss from some area, from somewhere, at what time, the clothes, the identification, whether is wearing a turban, a spectacle, human beings, looks, features, complexion, okay, the mental health of the person who is missing, date since when is missing, last seen when and where. Then you can talk about the contact and promise of reward to the finder. Okay, lost and found is another category way. You need to describe the article lost, date, time and location of loss. If recovered, by whom and where to contact. Reward promised. You can mention a reward. Whosoever finds that briefcase should hand over to you and he would be rewarded. Right? Warning and caution you can give. Example, against unlawful use by the finder. He should not misuse whatever he had found. The next ad can be travels and tours, where you need to mention the name of the company, agency, okay, tours, cruises, sightseeing offered, accommodation they would provide, duration and date of tour, okay, whether it is for couples or single, accommodation, food and mode of transport, visa requirements and assistance in visa process, booking period, quality of service, contact address including email, phone number and website. Now children, if you find something, same way you have to mention description of the article found, okay, withhold vital details you need to give and the identification, what was there in it. If you find something, invite the owner to claim. The owner has to come and claim by giving the identification of his article. Okay, what was there in it? So he has to mention that, only then that particular thing would be returned back to him, and then the contact number and the address. Okay, they can be a vehicle for sale. Okay, vehicle can be for sale, making Maruti, Tata, Honda, model, mileage, color, accessories, stereo, okay, AC, heater, alloy wheels, then seat covers, condition, excellent, accident free, mileage, ownership details you can give, is a doctor or is driven by a lady, well maintained, license plate number you can mention, okay, kilometers run, how many kilometers it has been driven, insurance details, price expected, contact name and address. And in the same way, sometimes you can even miss your kennel. Okay, kennel is nothing but it's a dog. So you need to mention the breed of the dog, his name, age, you know, and color, looks, whether it has been vaccinated or no, it is a trained dog or untrained, registration with Kennel Club of India, price expected, contact number and the phone. Then another one can be even change of address or making an appeal by certain organizations, you know, to help out someone. So in such ads, you can mention about the nature of appeal. Then, you know, you can talk about the help required, whether it is wanted in cash or in kind. Then you can mention a word of sympathy for victims. Then, you know, you can even talk about the credentials of the individual, organization making the appeal, contact address and telephone number. So I have given you brief information about the value points that you can add in different categories, children, and classify. I hope, children, with the help of these value points, you would be able to, you know, draft your classified advertisements, you know, and score full 4 marks in this question. Okay, now with this, for better understanding of the format and how you are supposed to write, I have given here as an example one of the classified ads for sale. Okay, heading is always supposed to be written in block letters, children. Keep it in mind. Then you need to leave one line space, and then the content, which is to be written in phrases or in words, then the contact address, then phone number and the name. Okay, as I have written here, available 8-seater sofa, teak wood in excellent condition, then the center table, glass center table, godrej, steel almirahs, 5 Usha fans, 1 microwave, 1 toaster, food processor, 1 LG fridge. See, these are just the phrases written here, and I hope you would be able to do it. Now, children, with this, we end the classified ad category, and now I would like to move on to the next, newspaper category, that is advertisement. That is display or non-classified ads. Now, display advertisements can be of any size, shape and color. In these, we can make freely the use of visuals like sketches, you know, designs, drawings and images. Font size of letters depends upon the artistic need of the advertiser. These advertisements aim at spreading public awareness, making appeals, announce sale, discount, inaugurations of shops or showrooms, admission notices, and children, what not. Another thing, display advertisements cost far more than the classified advertisements. And that's the reason classified advertisements, you know, you can give the maximum information in a short paragraph by writing less words. You use only, you know, words and phrases in the classified ad. Now, another thing is, you are free to play with your words when you're drafting a display advertisement. Repetition of sounds, words and ideas, catchy phrases and slogans, visuals can be
used in the display advertisements, children. Okay, now as I told you, you can make it more attractive, catchy and decorative one. And information given in the non-classified ad must be very clear, because the main bottom line to publish these ads is that these ads should attract the attention of the customers. Okay, got it? Now children, here I have put up two display ads for you to understand better: the name of the company of the pen, then the size, the colors, the sizes available, then if you are giving any discount on it or any free set of pens, you can mention all that in different font sizes. And to make it appear more attractive and catchy, you can use certain slogans too. Okay, the next ad, one more I have given here, it is example of non-classified ads, so that you would be able to understand the difference between the classified and the non-classified ads. Okay, here you can make the images, the sketches you can show, you can use different font sizes to put up your content. And remember, the format is going to be the same, but only how you are going to design it, that is going to be different. There you are going to write only theoretical in the classified, whereas in the non-classified you can, you know, give the images, designs, sketches you can do. So I hope, children, you all have followed what I'm trying to, you know, explain to you, as my language, my expressions are always simple, so that you can, you know, get benefited out of what I'm trying to explain to you. So please kindly keep working hard and do your best in the forthcoming examination. I wish you all a good day, and with this we end today's lecture. Thank you all very much. Keep yourself safe indoor and keep improving your immunity, as we are still fighting COVID-19. Good days ahead to all of you. Take care.